As you watch this video, you will learn more about logic and how you can use that to improve your coding skills. More logic with the Python coder. In if-else statements, we only have two options. In real life, we have more choice. Here, we can choose one of four options: coffee, tea, water, juice. In this example, we also can choose only one option: small, normal, large, extra large. In a menu system, we may push a button and something happens. So in this example, we had three buttons. We push the first one, which shows A, number two shows B, number three shows C. These are all examples where we have multiple choice. Not. If free, pay nothing. Else, pay money. If something doesn't cost anything, we don't need to pay. But if we do have to pay something, then we have to pay money. So that's an if-else statement. We can change that using not. If not free, pay money. This does the same as the previous if-else, but just uses the word not. So not changes the condition to the opposite. We said using the space, the indentation was important, and would explain more. So here we're going to look at blocks, code that's put together. Here we're going to make some coffee. So if coffee, boil kettle, add milk, add sugar. All of these things are together. Because they have the space underneath the if statement, we know they're part of that if statement. So if coffee, do all of these. If not, don't do any. So can you see that space? You can see the block here shows you that indentation of all these lines. Here, if by fruit, choose fruit, pay money, receive change, take fruit. All of these things are part of the if statement. We can see that block again. Nested if statements means an if inside another if. We've looked at if rain, use umbrella. But you wouldn't do that if you was inside. So here we've got if outside, if rain, use umbrella. So if you're inside, you wouldn't look at the rain part because it's not relevant. So here we've got an if statement inside another if statement. So let's look at the block, the indentation again. So we can see the if rain is part of the if outside code, and then the use umbrella is part of the if rain. Another example, when we bought the fruit before, we said choose fruit, pay money, receive change, take fruit. But we would only receive change if we had some change. If it was the correct money, we wouldn't. So here we can add in another if statement saying if there is change, receive the change. So again, look at our blocks. So all of this code is part of if by fruit, but the receive change only happens if there is some change. You see the second block? You can see how the indentation shows you which text, which lines are part of the if statements. So if change, receive change, that's nested. That's the nested if statement. It's inside. Nested means inside. If first day of the month, if it's January, happy new year. Else, it's a new month. So that's an if else statement inside, nested in an if statement. The first block shows us the first if statement. All of that underneath is part of that. Then we have the block from the if January, and then we have the block for the else, so we can see which bit belongs to which if statement or else. The order you put things in, where you place them, is very important. The next section shows you this logic. The next four examples look similar, but they are very different. Here we can see the car, and it's going to go through some coloured blocks. If we look, it's always going through the red block, and then it has a choice to go through the blue block if left, or if it turns right, go through green. We will see if it goes straight, it will just go through the red block, but it always goes through the red block. Here we've got a choice. The car will either go left, go through blue, go right, go through green, or straight ahead. But it will go through one of the colours. Here the car has a choice. It can go through blue or green or no colour, and then afterwards it will always go through red. The final example, the car can turn left and go through blue and red, can go right and go through green, or if it just goes straight, it doesn't go through any colour at all. So those four are similar, but they are very different. So why is this important? Let's give you an example. Blue is have a shower, green is have a bath, and red is get dressed. So let's have a look at these examples again. Okay, here we have a choice. We can have a shower, we can have a bath, but we always get dressed. Here we get dressed, have a shower, or have a bath, or have neither. So we're going to get dressed first, even before the shower and bath. Here we have a shower and get dressed, or we have a bath or nothing at all. So that means it's fine if we have a shower, but we don't get dressed if we have a bath. Here we can either have a shower or have a bath or get dressed. If we have a shower or a bath, we won't get dressed. So you can see that in these examples, although they're similar, they all have very different outcomes. So when you're writing code, order and the place of where you put things is very important. We've covered quite a lot, so we're going to stop there, and we're going to include the rest in a second video. So please join us for that. And of course, if you haven't already, please subscribe.